Chapter 6, Section 4, Root Cause Analysis. Root cause analysis is concerned with the relationship between issues and factors. The idea is that when we want to change something about the issues, we need to understand the factors that contribute to them. If we then change something about the factors, we hope that the issues do not arise anymore. But how do we identify relations between issues and factors? We look at two different options here. We may start with the issues. If we know about an issue, we can ask, why did this issue occur? It may give us an explanation. From that explanation, we may ask again, why did something happen that this explanation materialized? Why diagrams are a means to help structuring asking these why questions. We may also look at cause-effect diagrams. They formulate potential categories of how factors and issues are related. We can go through these categories and identify which connections are plausible. Mind that both why-why diagrams and also cause-effect diagrams are about formulating a rich set of hypotheses. When we have a long list of potential hypotheses, we can systematically validate them and check which are the ones that are really the most important ones. So how are why-why diagrams designed? We start from an issue and we ask a why question. Through answering that why question, we may identify a contributing factor. Potentially, there are several factors that could be relevant. At this stage, we do not yet know which ones are the most relevant ones. The idea of the why-why diagram is to ask 5 times the why question in a row. That means for a contributing factor, we again ask why, and we get previous contributing factors, and so forth, and so forth, such that we have chains of 5 steps of contributing factors. This gives us a rich cascade of factors that we can then step by step verify. Let's look at an example. The site engineers keep equipment longer. Why is that the case? It might be that the site engineer fears that equipment will not be available later than needed. So why is that? Well, maybe because the time between the request and the delivery is too long. Why is that? Because excessive time might be spent in finding suitable equipment and approving the request. So why does that take so long? Because the time spent by clerk contacting possible multiple suppliers is done sequentially. Or that the time spent waiting for works engineers to approve. You see, by step asking these why questions, we come down to the root causes. A complementary way is to use the cause-effect diagram. It is also called fishbone diagram or Ishikawa diagram. Here we have the issue on the right-hand side, and we start also with 6 categories of potential causal factors. All these categories of factors start with M. We also call these the 6 M factors. On the left-hand side top, we start with measurement. This means that the success associated with the process may be different, may be measured in different ways. Maybe the way how we measure gives us a wrong idea. The second is material. This is related to the inputs of the process. Maybe with them something is wrong, and that causes the issue. Third is machine. This is any technical equipment that is involved in the process, potentially contributing to issues. We continue with method at the right-hand side, bottom. Method is associated with how the process is defined and organized. Maybe the way how we do the process contributes to issues. Then comes man. This is associated with any men working in the process, in how far their imperfections may lead to certain issues. Finally, there's milieu. Anything that is surrounding the process in its surroundings, surrounding environment, such as suppliers, customers, their characteristics and their traits may actually have an impact on issues. Let's look at an example again from our equipment rental. The issue is equipment rejected at delivery. The idea of the cause-effect diagram is that we now go through each of the categories and try to think about potential plausible explanations. Let's start with material. It could be that the clerk selected equipment with incorrect specification. Why could that be the case? Well, maybe because there's an inaccurate equipment description in the catalog. There could be also an explanation in the category machine. Machine also involves computing machinery, that is, information technology and systems. The system does not keep the site engineers informed. That could be the explanation here. There's something about method. The site engineer does not validate the choice of equipment. That is something that is defined as such or not in the process. There's something about man as well. The clerk may have misunderstood the site engineer's requirements. You see that we get a long list of potential explanations, potential factors. All these may be contributing to the issue. Now, the idea with the cause-effect diagram is that we want to find as many plausible explanations as possible. Once we have compiled such an extensive list, we need to check and verify if the plausible explanations actually truly make sense in the context of the process. We recap. In this chapter, we looked at value-adding analysis. We segregated value-adding, business value-adding, and non-value-adding steps. We also looked at waste analysis, where we identified different types of wastes in the categories move, hold, and overdue. We also looked at how we can organize issues in an issue register, assessing their impact, helping to prioritize them. Finally, we analyzed root causes by the help of YY diagrams and cause-effect diagrams.